Hi friends, welcome to Ideas at Home. Today I have came up with a vlog. It was raining in the morning. The day's cooking starts with making tea. But I do make sure to have a cup of water, plain water, before I have the tea. Having a cup of hot tea in the morning really relaxes my mind. How about you all? For the breakfast, I had made green peas carrot curry. I had soaked the green peas previous night itself, so making green peas curry was really easy in the morning. Along with green peas, I am making chapati. I'll show you the three ways in which I usually make chapati at my home. Here, this is the first method. I'm using a cast iron tawa here. For this kind of chapati, I'll add a little of ghee also. It's really tasty this way. I usually make the dough just before I make the chapati. Cast iron tawa gives high heat, so you can make the chapatis very quickly in this tawa. This is the second method of making chapati, or rather roti. Here I have kept a lightweight tawa. It's not a cast iron tawa, it's an iron tawa. Place the rolled roti on low flame. Cook for 2 to 3 minutes. Flip it over. Make the flame to high and wait until bubbles come. When bubbles come, just keep take it with a tong and then put it directly on the flame, and then your roti will be ready. In this method, you don't need any ghee or oil. The roti will be super soft. You can see how soft it is. Now I'll show you the third method of making chapati. It is sort of high calorie chapati because you need a lot of ghee in this method, but it's really tasty and it is called square chapati, or in Malayalam it is called chadra chapati. After rolling the dough as usual, we have to apply 1 teaspoon of ghee. You can also use oil instead of this, but ghee tastes better. And then fold on both sides like this, and also the other two sides also like this. And now roll again. You can make this in triangle shape also. Now while making also, I am adding 1 teaspoon of ghee. This tastes best when we are adding ghee in between while making rolling the dough, and also while cooking in the tawa. On both sides we have to spread ghee like this. You can also use oil. But as I said, ghee tastes the best. So our chapati is also ready. So I'm serving the chapati with the green peas curry as a breakfast. After the breakfast is made, there are a lot of utensils to be washed. First, I'm going to clean the sink thoroughly. Here I'm using a Sif kitchen cleaner. We just need a small quantity of Sif to clean this sink. Sometimes I use a Vim liquid itself, but this Sif is a little more stronger and it gives a sparkling effect on the stainless steel kitchen sink. Using a brush, I'm going to just clean the whole sink area inside. and also on the sides. In our present situation, most of us have to handle all the household chores single-handedly without any house help. As kids are also full-time with us, we need to engage them also, and also we have to, as mothers, we have to help them in their studies. Kids are also feeling very bored without meeting their friends, and they are missing the parks, beach, everything. We all have to take an extra effort to stay motivated and to stay positive even in this negative situation. We have to try to spend our time fruitfully, keeping ourselves busy with whatever we like to do, or to develop a skill, or to read a good book, or whatever we enjoy doing will help us to stay positive and calm. Now, a major task, that is washing the dishes after the breakfast, is almost over now. I have hanged the kitchen glove also to get it dried. Mid-morning, I made a refreshing juice which is made with this fruit, that is passion fruit. Some of you will be familiar with this fruit. There are a lot of seeds inside, and you have to take this out, this pulp out, and just leave the outer part away. There is a passion fruit plant in our house. We can make a passion fruit juice in two ways. One is in mixie method without it. I have added the pulp of two passion fruit in the mixer grinder and added the required amount of sugar. And now I am going to add in water. I have taken 2 cups here. And then make a juice out of it. Now you have to sieve it, and your tasty passion fruit juice is ready. In the second method, into the pulp of one fruit, add in the required amount of sugar and simply add water and stir well until the sugar dissolves well, and your juice is ready in this method also. Passion fruit is a nutrient-dense fruit with vitamin C, vitamin A, antioxidants and fiber in it. It's a refreshing drink made at home. For lunch, we got a special fish called pearl spot fish or karimeen in Malayalam. This fish is considered a delicacy in Kerala and it is commonly found in black waters of Kerala. Into the washed and clean fish, I have added pink salt, 3 teaspoons of chili powder, 1/4 teaspoon of turmeric powder, 1/4 teaspoon of fennel seeds powder, and 1/2 a lime. I have added pepper powder also for an additional flavor and marinate the fish pieces. Keep it aside covered for an hour so that all the masala gets coated in the fish pieces very well. To fry the fish, I am using a cast iron skillet. This is cast iron skillet from Lord's brand. I've kept the cast iron skillet on medium flame and allowed the skillet to get heated up well before pouring oil. When the pan is really heated up, I have added the required amount of coconut oil. The handle of the skillet will be very hot. You will need a cotton towel to hold it. You can also use silicone pan holders available nowadays. The oil is also really hot now. You can see the fumes coming. Now we can fry the fish. I'm placing the fish pieces into the hot oil. This particular fish tastes best when fried with more oil and in medium flame. That will help the fish to get crispy. In this large cast iron pan or any other cast iron pans, you can use any types of ladles. You can either use metal spoons like this or wooden spoons like this. But it's always best to use metal spoons in cast iron cookwares. While it's getting fried, we'll add in some curry leaves. This will give an added flavor to the fried fish. When one side of the fish is done, we'll slowly flip it. When the fish is ready to flip, how we'll understand is that it will come off from the pan on its own. That means it's ready to get it flipped. We have to wait until that particular time to flip it over, otherwise it might stick to the bottom. Now both sides of the fish is perfectly done. We'll take the fish pieces out from the oil. As we have fried in little more oil, the outer portion of the fish will be very crispier. The yummy karimeen fry is ready. Those of you who haven't tried this fish should definitely have a try. It's really tasty. I had also made a simple mor curry with cucumber and curd. I usually make rice in a cooker. We use matta rice. Along with this, we had a vegetarian dish that is beans toran, and I have made it also in a cast iron kadai. Hope you have enjoyed this vlog. It's raining here again. See you soon. Until then, bye bye.